with Bob, I said to the interviewer, said, why they don't want to smoke this thing here? Why? You know?
Yeah, man. Yeah. It's when Bob them interviewed it, and what Bob touched on is because it really free up the mind. And when people mind them free, I'm going to give you a straight rasta talk like Bob right now.
Yeah.
The truth of the matter is, when you look at the thing, you know, it's a plant we're talking about, you know, brother. All yeah. I mean, if you legalize a plant where you put on earth and grow in a sign.
Yeah.
All man get that authority over God creation. You don't have to legalize nothing. We as people for know how to eat the food. We grew up in a Jamaica yeah. with these things.
Yeah.
Yeah, but then take control of it. Put it under the law and then say, all right, to get a license for grow this thing, you can't even have a previous criminal record. So if them hold you before with a split tear, brethren, yeah. you can't apply for no license for grow ganja. You see how them lock up the real yeah. ganja man out yeah. of this thing?
That may I say so. That's for sure. So, to me, I think it's just a money-making thing and with the government. Is it?
Yes and no. And this is why I really love Canada. I'm going to yeah. tell you the truth. I love this place. Because there are some people that really fought big money. Some young people out of BC and Toronto carry literally the government to the Supreme Court.
Yeah.
And challenge them on some of these legislations they were writing.
Yeah.
And in 2015, they won. So July 2015, you had what they call the ACMPR regulations that became in effect in Canada.
Yeah.
This is for persons who want to have access to medical marijuana.
Yeah.
Yeah, you are somebody who you have, you know, chronic arthritis or back pain or yeah. cancer patient or epilepsy
yeah.
or many of the other symptoms that we know ganja is a medicine for.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can apply through that process. That's what we do at Jamaica Grow Academy. We help people now who don't want to have to wait till regulations come for recreational.
Yeah.
You can come through us. We partner with certain medical clinics here in Calgary and across Canada.
Yeah.
We'll get you in to see a medical professional. They'll look at your case and they will simply say, okay, you have back pain. And you simply say to them, yes, I'd rather to have a natural remedy than an artificial one. That is where ganja come into mainstream now.
Yes.
So I love Canada for that, because some young people fought the government that now, when you come under us like the Jamaica Grow Academy, you can
yeah.
legally, right now, once you get your license, we help you with that right now, you can grow ganja in your house. You can grow ganja for people, other medical marijuana patients,
yeah.
and make a business out of growing ganja right now.
So, before we move on, it seems like you were telling before the break, before we play legalizing, you were telling me how you come by the name.
Yeah.
The name. So,
never,
go back to the name. I want to know, I saw me saying, I want to know what the meaning behind certain name. You know?
Yeah, all right.
You know?
All right. So,
before you said, it's just like when we see some of them girls have put Chinese tattoo.
You could have said it's just a fancy writing, it could be anything.
So yeah, so yeah. tell me.
All right, I'm going to touch just the first part of the name.
Yeah.
Because when I say the word, most listeners won't understand. The name of our operation is Jamaica Grow Academy.
Yeah.
But the Jamaica spelled different.
I don't realize though.
The Jamaica. Jamaica spelled
yeah.
different for a reason, because the Jamaica, the first part of the word is J A H.
Yes.
Ja. Ja come first.
Yeah.
Everything we do is about Ja creation.
So, question, are you a Rasta man? Are you a Rastafarian?
No, I don't know what Rastafarian means.
Rastafarian.
No, I'm telling you why I don't know what Rastafarian means.
Yeah.
Because right now, if you go back to here, you're yeah. going to see all heap of man all over the place with locks.
Yeah.
Normally, when I was growing up, for me see a man with locks in it, you call him a Rasta man.
Yeah.
Or a Rastafarian.
Yeah.
There is a man that used to walk through the community with all a cell broom.
Yeah.
Broom.
Yeah.
And you go down on the market, them man is one them selling them herbs and these
yeah.
different things. Rasta man, you could have easily identified
yeah.
back in the day.
Yeah.
Now, a whole pass show play a fairy tale Rasta.
Yeah, yeah.
You
yeah,
look
yeah.
for me, you know, you just yeah. see me, my locks
are yeah, yeah. Back. You know, yeah. I'm just gonna say, yo, you try with the locks of it
now. No, my locks not try, but I show you, my sport a different thing, you know, where
so, yeah.
my locks just do whatever it want.
Yeah.
But if you didn't know me from when I was a youth in yeah. college, you know, you don't know about me.
Yeah.
So me was a man with locks. From them day that as a little boy coming yeah. up, I didn't have my locks from college days.
Yeah.
You know me cut my locks better? When me left college and go back to Jamaica, young engineer and have all my yeah. degree and everything, yeah. you know. And well smart and come from people who they say, yeah, them know your father.
Yeah.
All of a sudden I went back to Jamaica and I realized Rasta was not accepted. My wow. locks was not accepted.
Yeah.
So having locks in Jamaica, meant that you might not get a particular job.
Yes,
or you're not going to get invited to certain parties and people going to scan you.
Yeah.
They don't understand that Rasta is more than Ganja. Ganja is just a part of the Rasta thing.
Yeah.
Just like him when I said to the Catholic Church, well, you have your communion around wine and bread.
Yeah.
We, our holy herb is Ganja. But I am more than that. So when I say to people, yeah, I'm a Rasta and I talk it straight, that don't mean I don't believe in Christian principles.
Yes.
You
yes,
understand
yeah,
me?
Yeah.
Because so me grew. And yeah. I believe in God. And I believe in Jah. So the simple way to put it, brother, I was taught to be a Christian, but me born Rasta. Because Rasta come from right. inside away. Ganja make for be in a way, body.
Yeah.
And everything I talk to right now is under inspiration of Ganja.
Hey, I'm only gonna be a prophet tonight. Hey,
are you sick? I know me.
You man sound like a prophet, like yeah, you know.
Well, brother, I tell you, is you know, I really have a heart for the people.
Yeah.
For me, Ganja thing is not about making money. We start Jamaica Grow Academy, and I want to give a real big up to all of my students. Them we sign up. We have been oversubscribed for the new course that we are starting in a couple weeks from now. We have been at a couple cannabis expos, the last two expos, one in Edmonton and in Calgary. We're having a nice little Grow 420 launch party this weekend. And I tell you, we are already over capacity for students saying, can you teach us to grow? Because what I am saying to the students is not just about making the money, you know, but I'm going to really show you how we do it in Jamaica, the real Rastaman heart.
Yeah.
When we go and we beat with kettle drum.
Yeah.
I don't know, want to know why Jamaican weed so strong, because we know if a big kettle drum strong.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's a good thing now for Canada. Because I see for the first time, if it's one thing I want to bring across to the community, anybody who's hearing me, I have been a part of one major industry that is starting from the beginning. When they broke up the monopoly in Jamaica about yeah. telecoms.
Yes.
Whole heap of people make millions of dollars.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, I don't care what you see or think about Ganja. If you want to change your life and the life of your children, get to know the plant.
Yeah.
There's a reason over $25 billion of rich man money is pumping into this thing.
Yeah.
They are not putting it there thinking they are going to lose it. Deals have already been struck between Canada, I don't even call the details, between yeah. Canada and other countries,
yeah.
between Jamaica and other countries for export. You have an opportunity to take advantage of what has been given to us by Bob and all these other men and bring your life to another level. Just legalize the thing.
Hey, man, I tell you. You listen to Fiwe Radio right here, you know, in Calgary, Toronto, Edmonton. I want to give a shout out. So, yeah, we'll be in here with the expert, you know, talking about cannabis, about legalization. You know, we're in here with the expert talking how you can grow it, what it's good for, you know, and anything. Because I believe, for my situation is that I just think that Jamaica is just late to the game. You know, I think that Jamaica should have jumped behind when the, you know, from the beginning, from the get-go, to let this thing happen, you know. And right now you have big company with billions and billions of dollars when we think that same billions and billions of dollars that could have helped liquor Jamaica. Enough work, man, could I get a yard in them?
Yeah, and look how what is happening in yard right now. Right now you have Canadian companies in Jamaica growing ganja legally. Just recently, you had the first legal dispensary opened up in Jamaica. And listen to me, people, you're not going to believe this. You know that if you're a Jamaican citizen and you walk into this dispensary in Ocho Rios right now, close to the cruise ship here, you as a Jamaican can't buy ganja, but the tourists... You as a Jamaican right now cannot legally walk into this dispensary. This dispensary is being given a license by the government of Jamaica. And a Jamaican cannot go in there. But a tourist with a medical marijuana can go in there and buy Jamaican ganja. Oh no, wake up.
Jesus. Is there a thing, yeah? Seriously. You know, before we continue, we're going to cool on the pressure. Yeah?
And you can't be prophet, you should have never been.
One more Peter Touch.